Lions TV post-match analysis video from my car this time. I just got full beamed in the eyeballs. I'm working late tonight and I ain't going to get a chance to go and do it, so I've got to do it in the motor. Firstly, yeah, now we're sponsored by Ladbrokes. Massive thanks to our old sponsor, McFinn Services. What a man he was. He really helped me out and got the channel off the ground. I really appreciate everything he's done for us and did us a real big favour by standing down. He didn't have to, and top man for that. Thanks a lot. Right, moving on to another top man involved at Mill, Neil Harris. Listen, let's start by saying this. Neil Harris is a Mill legend. We all know that. We all respect him. There's not one Mill fan that doesn't want Neil Harris to succeed at this job. Everyone wants Neil Harris to absolutely succeed at this job. All we want for him is to become not only one of the best Mill players of all time, but the greatest manager of all time. But I'll be honest with you, and I felt this way for a while, he's going to be struggling to do that. The one simple reason is he's not very tactically astute. And what we see on the pitch, the end product, I don't think warrants the amount of time they get to train. I don't know what else they're practicing. Our set pieces are shocking, our throw-ons are shocking. And what we really, really need, I wouldn't usually agree with this, but in this case, we'll make the exception. And I really appreciate and I'm fully in with everyone, you know, how loyal we are to people that we love. But he needs help. He either needs help from an experienced number two. Dave Livermore's a yes man. I know that for a fact. I've been told that from people at the club. He needs a number two who can help him out, you know, tactically and get this team going again, because we are absolute dog shit. It is a fact. We haven't played well all season. We've gone back from this time last year, we've gone backwards and in a big way. We done so well to the back end of last year. We started this season okay, then we tailed off. We got it back a bit, but games we've dominated for a long, long time, we haven't dominated a game. I think I can look back and say Bristol Rovers at home, I know they was down to 10 men, and probably Charlton at home in the second half was some really good spells. We played well. We can do it in the cup, so I can't understand why we can't do it in the league. That's the worrying thing. We can get motivated for cup games, and that is what Harris is relying on. He's a motivator and he wants to play direct, but what he's got to accept now is what we're doing is not working. It's no longer working and it needs to change, and he's either got very strong beliefs or he's stubborn, and he needs to bite the bullet and accept that 4-4-2 and direct balls to Morrison is not going to work. Morrison isn't right, and I've seen an Instagram early from Harry Smith saying he's looking forward to getting back out there. So changes absolutely have to be made. And I've said this before, I'll be amazed if he doesn't make changes tomorrow. If we go to Sheffield United tomorrow and we play a flat 4-4-2 and play long diagonals to Morrison, we will lose the game. Without an absolute shadow of a doubt, we will lose the game 2, maybe 3-0. We need to change things up. We need to go attacking. We need to get the ball. We need to attack teams through the middle. We need to show a bit of flair and a bit of aggression, a bit of passion. The cut runs massively, but it's come back to bite us in the arse. That's an absolute fact. But listen, we all want Harris to succeed. I've said it and I'll say it again. We all want Harris to succeed. Of course we do. But we won't follow these. A lot of people, including myself, don't just want to keep following it blindly. Things need to change. He needs to accept it needs to change and make the statement. He seems to say the right things after the games, but he doesn't act on it, you know. We've got to sort this out, because if we don't get out of this division soon, we never will. And some people say we're not fussed about being in the lower leagues. You should be. And the reason being is that the gulf between the Premier League and the Championship is big enough. The gulf between the Championship and League One is getting even bigger. And we'll end up either existing in League One, or we're going to drop down the leagues lower and lower and lower. And the people that don't want to move to Kent, me included, even though I'm from Kent, we will end up there because the ground will be too big for us. We already run at a loss in that ground. We need to get back in the Championship. Listen, I don't want to go any further than that. Let's survive there, but we've got to get back in this Championship. We've got to go out of this league. We've got to make the playoffs. I'm running out of steam now. I'll leave it there. Please subscribe to Lions TV. Another full beam right in the direct in your eyeball. Thanks, mate. And I will see you at Sheffield United tomorrow if you're going. Come on, you Lions.